Guys, this Armin here. Welcome to another indie game in the series. Put out a few earlier here, but I thought I'd do one on Kerbal Space Program. Fun game, not out officially yet. It's still in early access. It's an simulation game, indie, that was developed by and published by Squad. Haven't heard that company before. Was released last year in the 20th of March and is sold for about 25 euros, I think it is. You might think it's a little bit pricey, but I can assure you it's worth it. I spent about 60 to 80 hours in this game and I completely love it, because well, you build spaceships and you try to either go around the Kerbal place, or you go to the moon, or you go to some other planet, or you have a whole solar system, for fuck's sake, that you can go to. It's your mind that sets the limits in this game. And I'm gonna jump right in, because I'm not much for talking about the settings and things like that. We can talk about a little bit. General is flight UE size really good, so you don't get like buttons that are really big on the things, and you can mess around with the max persistent debris and things like that, and full rebindable keys, and everything has a function. There's no grouping of keys on this one. So you have flight controls, you have staging controls, everything from rotation to God knows what. You have docking UI, you have control of the Kerbals, which is pretty fun when you go out from the ship, base ship, and start moving around with the Kerbal. Rovers and other things and shit, if I know what that is. And the graphics option is pretty basic. It's not much to mess around with, but it's some. And then you have the volume, so that's how it looks. And we're gonna jump in, and I'm gonna use one that I've already used. Also, this is a sandbox game, so it's gonna take some time to load. This is a sandbox game, so you basically do whatever you want, unless you want to play the career mode, because then you can have the option of doing missions and unlocking the things that you want, and doing science and things like that, research and everything. But we're not gonna do that. We're gonna try and jump in, build a spaceship, if I can just remember. Oh, you need to put one down. I'm gonna go with the MK12 command pod. Now I can move around up and down and in and out. Okay, with that, we're gonna do a fairly simple rocket. I think we're gonna do what the hell am I doing? Yeah, I don't know what to do. Is it that one? No, it's not that one. Is it that one? No, it's not that one. It's... that's the one I want. And I would want this. Oh yeah, SAS is crucial when you build a spacecraft, because it makes the spacecraft steady, so it doesn't wobble and things like that. So when you turn it on, it stays. I'm not gonna put it there. We're gonna put first a structure. We're gonna have a decoupler. Separators. There we have it. And we're gonna have that one, and we're gonna have the tank under that one. And also for this one, we're gonna have I think it is a parachute you need to have. Yeah. Parachute is good. Parachute is good. And we can do not free parachutes. We don't need free parachutes. We need what's the difference between these two? Mass 2, mass 3. Oh, okay. We're gonna do like that. That's just perfect. Okay. And as you see down here, it's started to mess around with my options. This is the staging operation. So as I put more things on this, it's gonna rack up a lot here. And when you get out, you have the staging option when you activate different degrees of the stages. And lastly, you want the parachute, because you don't want the parachute contained with in the beginning, because then it's gonna fuck it up. So very important, parachute lastly after you decouple everything, because if you have this tank connected and the parachute and you can't get it off, it's gonna ram it into the ground really fast, and that's gonna kill the Kerbals inside, and that's not very good. What more can we do? We can put a rocket on there. What should we do with a rocket? We should we'll take. As I'm gonna use helpers for this one, I'm gonna put down that one, and it has only 650 max frost, and the other one has 1500. But as I need a little more fuel to get this actually into orbit, I'm gonna be a little bit saving on that one and instead put down, is it those? I think it is. Is it? And max frost 20 monopropellant. No, we need liquid fuel and oxidizer. Yeah, that's what we need. And we're gonna do we're gonna do like that. Yeah, that's the one. That looks perfect. And also what we need is we're gonna put this down here so I know where I am, and we're gonna need the couplers, I think it is called. Yeah, the couplers. Not that one, the small ones. Not that many. We're gonna need 5 of them, I think. And we're gonna put them around there-ish. Yeah, there-ish. No. Put them like this. And we're gonna use... We're gonna use... What are we gonna do? We're gonna use fuel boosters. Oh shit. That looks scary. But I think it will work. I hope I hope it will work. I don't think it will work. I hope it will work. Hopefully this will work. I said I was gonna make a simple one, and now I'm just throwing shit into like crazy here. The decouplers are really useful, because when you put on extra rockets, if you want maybe to decouple them later on so they don't put on a lot of drag, you should definitely do that. And I'm gonna put in an option to turn that on and off. This one, number one, I'm gonna toggle that engine. Yep, and that's number one. Okay, so we got that one. Yeah. Yeah, we got that one. And After that, maybe we can put on some fins. Make it look really spacey. Spacey. And then we're gonna have some. What do we need? We need. Stabilizers. Stability enhancer. Okay, sorry. Where can I put that? I can put it like this. Ah, perfect. So when I fire. Gonna move these guys up here. So when I fire, I'm gonna fire, release those, fire that one, fire everything here, and the small ones. That's gonna hopefully work without blowing everything up. I will see if it blows up. It blows up. And we're gonna try this out. We're gonna make. Name it the track. No, it's not, please don't blow up. Save, and then we're gonna go to the launch area. It's gonna load. It's gonna take a lot of load. And now it's gonna go up, and we're gonna have a chance to. And also down here, you see this is moving. This is the how should you say the power for the engine. The only thing I can control the power on is that one and these small guys here, because these booster rockets. Once you fire them up, they're at full power and they can't be turned off. And also, turn on SAS. Really useful in the beginning. And we're gonna count down. We're gonna do 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and don't. So far, so good. And we're getting. Turn that off. Still going really good. It's working! It's working! That's not good. He blew up some of my small ones. That's not good. I'm gonna turn here. And we're gonna see on the map. There we are. Going up. It's going. Not that good. I still have fuel. I have a lot of fuel. So it's no problem. Should have done this in light instead because I can't see much of the rocket on this one. Come on! You can do it! I need to straighten up a little bit. Get more height. Come on. We're getting a little bit height now. It's working. It's working. Now we're gonna go down. this. Hopefully get some more forward speed on it before it cuts out. Come on! You can do it! It's gonna fuck up, isn't it? It's not gonna work. I wanted to work. I'm gonna have to turn them off. Yep. I'm gonna have to turn them off. Turn them off. Turn them off. Oh, sorry. My neighbor seems to be having fun with his music. Come on. Speed up time a little bit here. And I think I'm gonna try and land again because this didn't go exactly like I wanted it to. Stop there. Gonna see here if we can go forward a little bit. I could have gone into orbit, but I don't have any fuel to get back if I got him to go into orbit, so we're not gonna do that. We're gonna have him land again. Hopefully successfully, and it's gonna be a good one. Here we go. Now we're gonna start falling down here. Yep, now you see the lighting is coming up because you can start to see the sun. The graphics in this, because it's still a simple game, but the graphics are really cool when it comes to the lighting and things like that. I'm gonna go down and crash. It's not good. What we're gonna do is we're gonna separate that one. There he goes. And my little Kerbals. Also, you can look inside the ship. They look adorable. So if I wanted to, I could look at the stars. Ah, I see the sun. Yee. Now it's gonna start moving around a little bit. It's gonna start stabilizing for the wind flow. get my heat shield towards. It doesn't matter anyway, but I like to do it that way. Looks cooler, if I might add. Well, it wasn't a total mishap. It wasn't a total fuck up because I got into space and everything, and you got to hear the beautiful music and everything like that. Also, you have. I shouldn't have done that. I pressed the wrong button. No. Oh well. You have. Like you see here, you have a whole solar system to explore if you want. There's a lot of planets in there. And these are like things I've separated before. This is not good. I hope the parachute doesn't explode. Because then we're gonna be dead in the water. Oh, crap. It's gonna burn up. Oh, this is not good. Oh, maybe not. Hopefully not. Come on! You can do it! I will survive! Oh. Hopefully these guys will survive. I hope. I do hope. 450, 420, 380. That's the speed of the aircraft, by the way, on the surface and in orbit. So there's different speeds for the depending on where you look. This might just work, hopefully. Shouldn't have said that too soon. And also, drink coffee. Coffee is a good thing. Well, not if you get it in the wrong throat. Hey, we shall see, we shall see. Come on. And it's gonna hopefully activate. It's just the pre-release now. What you heard that there was the engine that fell to the ground. Come on. Oh, it released. Perfect. That's beautiful. The graphics on the ground is not the best, but what do you expect? The game isn't for textures on the ground, it's for the textures in outer space and things like that for simulation. And they've done a really good job at making it work. To some degree, at least. Some things need to be fixing, but I think they're gonna have that fixed by the time they officially make the release of the full game, so to speak. And we have touchdown! And we survived! Now I'm gonna jump out. Yay! And do a victory lap. Yay! Well, that was Kerbal Space Program. I hope you enjoy watching it as much as I enjoyed making the video. And keep tuned for more to come. And if you like it, click the subscribe button down below, and have a good day.